whatever it takes to make the right decision for your health, I want you to really focus on making that. When we look at our health, we get so wrapped up in, is it genetics or family history, or is it something that grandma or grandpa passed down to us? It really isn't. What it comes down to are the choices that we make every day. That's what matters. So when you look at your health and you see any situation that you might have, when you look at your health and you see, well, diabetes or high blood pressure, or most of the time, you've done that to yourself. And I know you don't want to hear that. I don't want to like point a finger, but the good news is that if you made a bunch of choices that's taking you down a path to where your body has come to a certain place, then guess what? That's good news, because that means you can take yourself to another place. You can make new choices today and really come out of where you are and be on the other side. I see so many people, and I have in clinical practice for years, where they had type 2 diabetes, they did certain things, and now they don't have type 2 diabetes. They had high blood pressure, massive, taking 3 medications. They dropped some weight, they followed our protocols, they ate the right eating plan, they took the right supplements, they did the right exercise consistently over time, and guess what? They came off the medications, and they live better, and they're thriving. And it's not just some happenstance, and some people are lucky. They put in the work. And that's what you have to do. You have to put in the work. Look, you don't realize this, but it takes a lot of work to gain a lot of weight. Did you know that? Now, you may have fun along the way eating the donuts and the fried chicken and the pizzas, but it takes a lot of work. It's a lot of calories that makes that happen. And yes, it's a lot of work to get off that weight. But I can tell you this, that work is worth it. And I promise you, most people, once they drop that weight, they don't go back.